द इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग द इन्वेस्टिगेशन सबमिटेड द फाइनल रिपोर्ट स्टेटिंग दैट द केस वॉज ऑफ अ सिविल नेचर एंड नो क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस हैड बीन मेड आउट द अपीलेंट फाइल्ड अ प्रोटेस्ट पिटीशन बिफोर द लर्नेड मजिस्ट्रेट स्टेटिंग इंटर आलिया दैट द एक्यूज्ड पर्संस हैड कोलूडेड विद द इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर एंड द स्टेशन हाउस ऑफिसर एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफिसर ऑन 22/10/2009 हैड कंक्लूडेड द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑब्जर्विंग दैट द डिस्प्यूट वॉज ऑफ द सिविल नेचर एंड इंटेंडेड टू सबमिट द फाइनल रिपोर्ट बिफोर द कोर्ट द अपीलेंट coming to know about the same submitted an application before the concerned area officer who taking note of the same handed over the investigation to another SSI of police on 24/11/2009 the said investigation officer recorded statements of the concerned sub registrar the chief executive officer of Greater Noida authority from whose statements it was evident that the accused persons were never the owners of the property in question and the original allottee had not appeared in the Greater Noida authority and not transferred any documents he also recorded the statement of original allottee who had stated that the property was allotted in her name in 2005 and on a proposal being made by Raghubinder Singh, a friend of her husband, to sell the property, she executed an agreement to sell in his favor. And a general power of attorney in the name of his wife, Savita Singh, at his instance, but possession was not handed over to them. He also examined one Sarad Kumar Sharma, who was a witness to the agreement to sell, and the power of attorney executed by the original allottee and said Sharma had stated that the general power of attorney was executed to implement the agreement to sell executed in favor of Raghubinder Singh. The investigating officer obtained an affidavit from the complainant which was kept in the case diary, and on 25/2/2010 it was recorded in the case diary that a criminal offence had been made out against the accused persons. The case diary also evinced that there was an effort for settlement between the informant and the accused persons, and the accused person were ready to return the amount of rupees 10500 to the appellant on 10/3/2010. He made an entry to file the charge sheet against the respondents under sections 420, 406, 567, 468 and 479 of the IPC. At this stage, the accused persons again colluded with the previous investigating officer and the station